Okay, so now I'd like to talk about another type of index, geospatial indexes in particular. Support for geospatial indexes in MongoDB give us the ability to perform queries for locations near another location. So the type of thing that a lot of phone apps will do when you're, say, looking for a nearby cafe. Now, the type of geospatial index that we're going to talk about is 2D geospatial indexes. MongoDB also provides support for spherical geospatial indexes, that is, those that take into account the curvature of the Earth. But I'll direct you to the documentation and our courses at MongoDB University if you're interested in learning more about those. So with 2D geospatial indexes, we're essentially thinking of our data as all lying on a Cartesian plane with values in the X direction and the Y direction. So in these situations, we have a query location of some kind, and what we want to find in response to queries are other items or documents that are close to this query location. So there's essentially three things you need to know about in order to construct a geospatial index in MongoDB. The first of those is that you need a field that holds a location, and the location needs to be stored as an array with first an X value and then a Y value. Now, you can name this field whatever you want. I've just chosen the name location here. It could be loc or position, point, anything you like, but it does need to follow this form of having the X value first and then the Y. The second thing you need to know about is that you need to ensure there's an index. You need to call ensure index and create an index on this particular field. So in this case, I would need to call ensure index specifying location as the field, and I would need to specify a direction here. We'll take a look at a specific example of that in just a bit. So again, we need to create an index now on this field that we have for our documents that we want to use in geospatial queries. And finally, the way we do queries against a geospatial index is through the use of the $near operator. So it's these three steps in combination that allow us to do something like this and get all of the documents that have a location near this one. So let's take a look at this in some code, and then we'll do an example query in the Mongo shell. So this is a script that I actually retrieved from the OpenStreetMap folks. This is a script that they wrote for putting OSM data into MongoDB. So you can see here that it's going to do iterative parsing of our OSM data, just like we did in a previous example back in lesson 3. Now, let's take a look a little bit further down first, because I want to show you the location field here. So for every node in this file, this script builds a value called loc, and it is composed of the latitude value and the longitude value for a node element in the XML file. Then it adds that field to the record that it's building up as it moves through the node that it's creating a document for. Okay, and then finally it will end up creating a document in MongoDB by doing an insert at some point. Okay, now using that location field at the very top of this code, ensure index is called, and ensure index is called using that location field, which stores the XY coordinates for nodes that are parsed out of the OSM XML file. Now, the syntax for ensure index is slightly different in PyMongo. It matches the syntax for the language here, which of course is Python. Okay? But then also, rather than passing a dictionary, what we pass instead is a list of tuples. So we pass the name of the field that we want to create an index on, as well as a direction. So these are constant values that are available to us in PyMongo, so we're not simply typing strings here, which is potentially very error prone. Okay, and you can see that ensure index is actually being used here to create several indexes. Here's another example where we're creating an index on ID, and we're specifying that we want that index to be created in ascending order. Okay, so technically speaking, Geo2D is a direction argument for ensure index. And the reason why it makes sense to think about this as a direction argument is because queries using the near operator will always return documents sorted by those that are nearest to the query location. Okay, so now let's take a look at an actual query. And bear in mind that the query that we're going to look at in the Mongo shell is a query against the collection that we created using this script. This is exactly the script that I used to create this collection and store documents in it within MongoDB. Okay, so let's take a look at a query here. Now, what I need to do is make sure that I'm using the OSM database. And then I'm going to query the nodes collection. That script we just looked at actually creates several collections, one of which is nodes. And these are based on the nodes tags that appear in the OSM dataset. Now, again, we're using the Chicago OSM dataset, just for point of clarification. Okay, so what I'm going to do here then is query this particular collection. And note that I'm querying against the location field, and I'm using the near operator. Okay, and I'm specifying a set of coordinates here. Okay, so this is the type of thing that an application might do in order to find restaurants or other amenities near the location of a user making the query. Okay, this is how we might do this sort of thing in the back end of an application that supports that type of functionality. Now, I'm doing one other thing here, and this is really just for purposes of this example. And you remember from a little earlier in the lesson when we looked at the tags that get applied to nodes, that there's this TG field in this collection. Okay, and just so that the data we get back is a little bit more interesting, I'm just ensuring that there is a TG field, that it actually exists, because then we'll have some data that has some names and other sort of tagging associated with it, so we can kind of figure out what's there near this particular location. Now, this location happens to be quite close to Wrigley Field, so what we're going to get are a number of restaurants, cafes, convenience stores, that sort of thing in that neighborhood. So imagine you've just walked out of Wrigley Field and you're looking to see what's nearby on your phone. This is the type of query we might do in the back end of an application to support that sort of thing. Okay, so here's our initial set of results. We could get more by typing IT here in the shell. All right, we can see there's a Jamba Juice, there's a school, church, convenience store, in this case, happens to be a Walgreens, Domino's Pizza, and a Dunkin' Donuts. Okay, so that's pretty much what you need to know in order to build geospatial indexes in MongoDB. We'll take a look at using geospatial indexes in the case study in the next lesson.